Yes, hello, my name is Jens Zygar and I am in Gongster's Paradise, Memphis Gong Chamber, and the day has come. Yes, the day where the world is finally seeing the long-awaited for Paiste Bronze Gongs. Like in Germany you say Bronze, like in English do you say Bronze? How do you say it in English?
Bronze.
Bronze, wonderful, yeah, Bronze, in German Bronze Gongs. Sounds so much more beautiful in English language, and yes, they are beautiful. I fell in love with them like right away, and they are epic, and I am, wow, I'm so overwhelmed that I didn't even get really into it, but as far as I can say from now, this point of perspective, it's a next level operation. Like contemporary gong culture has seen such a spread of variety of gongs that came up these days. So many people doing different kind of varieties of really high-end, very good gongs. But so, of course, we expect something special from Paiste to claim that they are, the number one in gong manufacturing. And so are they still going to be upfront? Yes, they are. Well, in my hand, this is what you see behind me is this wall of bronze gongs. There's a copy of the certificate, like the first set that you've seen in the video, and the certificate is in the safe probably. So this is a set number one, the first set ever. And just let me run briefly a little bit through this set and see what comes to my mind is, well, first of all, the set comes with a beautiful, you saw the box. Box is great, but the concept of the box, this whole environment, they have like the sticks, the mallets, and we are all aware that Paiste mallets are very good quality ever since. The metal grip, can we have wood as Zoner head? Well, here they are. Mallet grips, we have a M4, we have an M5, and we have a very special mallet, two special mallets. And so all this already shows where we are going to. We are going into a world of creativity. And a creativity of sound. So where to start? So obviously the first thing you realize, there are particular two gongs. They would remind you on the sound creation number three, the old earth. And yes, actually this is what it is. It is the concept of sound creation number three of the earth, but taken to another level in terms of the material. So instead of nickel silver, it is a bronze alloy, and I have it all written down in the paper so I'm be sure that I hand it out. Actually, it's copper, 92% copper and 8% tin. So how does this affect the sound? And it does affect sound very much, like in terms I would say it's more soft, more smooth. And probably as the material is that not that strong or not that hard, it's a little bit weaker. So there is more variety of in-between sounds. So you will have actually much more sounds than if you would compare them with the nickel silver gongs. Well, and there are kind of some mysteries that even I'm on the path of tracking. What's the mystery? For example, it starts with number zero. What's zero? And then it goes from zero out of nine, but well, we'll get to the mystery. So zero is reminding you on the original sound creation. No, number one is more the traditional sound creation type. This has much less worked on spaces on it, and when you would play them, this very nice weak bass that goes into right to the center of the sound, and then and more spots, so it opens, makes the sound more wide and not that focused. Well, anyhow, I was playing it before and it's just very touching and very warm. Yeah, I would say warm is the term that comes up to me. So we figured out by now what's the purpose of this gong. So when they are out new, it is not that they get names as like the planets, or even when the sound creation gongs at that time before they got their names, they were handed out, people were playing them, sharing their impressions, and through sharing their impressions, finally the gongs got a name. And so somehow it is happening with these gongs as well. But like the expert would say, let's just run through it. So this is the number two, and it somehow relates to the water gong of the sound creation series. Besides that, the inside, the inverted boss is much bigger. And so what would you expect this sound? So I was very surprised when I played it. I was even like, for me this would be like too much crashing. I would really explore the gong from the beginning of the sound. Doesn't really make sense to really splash into it. It depends on you. You can do what you want. There's no formula how to get into this. You just do it your way. You're invited to be creative, of course, and to enjoy. So we have a number four here, and somehow, yeah, it as well relates to the water gong of the sound creation when I was playing it. So I just would go fly around, keep on playing, and it's just, they are very emotional. Yes, very emotional. And this is, for us in the integral sound rep, we call them the emotion gongs. 7 different emotions, right? And explore the emotion. What is interesting is that now we have bronze back in the game. It is that bronze, the material, you know, we had the Bronze Age, and after we had the Iron Age. So, and not that we had iron gongs, but the metal alloy being processed. So now getting back the bronze memory of the collective, getting it into the contemporary situation. Well, like some people would say that in the Bronze Age, people had a much bigger connection with nature and with the kind of the tribe being emotionally together. So my vision would be that these gongs will support many people to open up the emotion status, to gather in the tribe and feeling together, like many becoming a group, probably this is about. But then, what do we know? We have the number 8. So one of the mystery actually is when it jumps from 2 to 4, what happened to number 3? So I had a chance to speak to Sven Meyer. Sven Meyer, he's the gong master who's in charge for the creation. Took him a decade together with his team, Ferdinand Petersen, of course, all the other guys, to develop these amazing gongs. And they are very, very sensitive, and not only that they look beautiful, but they're very sensitive for climate. They're very sensitive, the way the sounds modulate, as the material is quite weak. So they are very individual. They are different. In that way, if you would compare with the other Paiste gongs, that it is, they have more options to become your gong. Do you need all of the sets? Well, by any chance, if you can get it, of course, go for it. But I'm sure that every gong will stand for itself, and you just relate to the gong. You will play the gong that you feel comfortable the best with. So still, number 3 is missing. And when I was speaking with Sven, what happens to number 3? If you ask a gong master, and you have to wait till you get the answer. So, and well, we'll see what happened to number 3, right? It could be, where's number 3? And not only where's number 3, also where's number 7? What happens to number 7? But maybe they will come later. Okay, there need be more secrets that we're going to wait for. Anyhow, when we come to number 8, I was so surprised. No, I stopped. Still number 6 is up. So the number 6 obvious reminds us on the symphonic gong, and it is the concept of the symphonic, but brought into a bronze gong. So you can definitely immediately sense the difference of the material. It's very obvious these days so many happen. We have gongs from titanium. We have gongs of metal that I even don't know of, but like having the bronze on a standard of this high-end worked out advanced appearance is a great further step in the world of exploring. Well, what do we explore? We explore ourselves, right? Do we? And we take the gongs, the vibrations to explore ourselves. Having new gongs, having new materials, having new sounds is like you would explore new parts of yourself. And I think this is interesting. And when I got to this gong at number 8, of course, cosmic octave, the number 8, the octave, this is. So I was surprised because this is a new form that there's no. Well, probably the confrontation gong, but it just had one ring. So. This little feature is not about getting into the sounds, right? I want you to get into the sounds. I just want to give my opinion, my impression from the Bronze Gong series, as they are so new, and it's an opportunity just to say something about it. And number 9, finally, is another, the new concept. And oh, and... So, playing the gongs, I feel I want to play them rather than talk about it. But I want to definitely honor Paiste and all the team for getting this out to the world, and for everybody outside who's playing gongs, there's no way not to play with the Bronze Gongs and enjoy them to the max. I will enjoy them to the max, and well, looking forward to see you in real life, and then we share this playing experience together. Thank you very much.